Hello everyone. Today I'm going to pour on a Lazy Susan, and it's going to be an acrylic pour, no resin this time, because it's a commission, and I need to use the colors black, white, silver, and gray. And I saw in one of the videos of Anna-Marie Ridderhoff that she uses a measuring cup and poured out of it onto a surface, and I liked it so much, so that's also what I'm going to try to do. So I'm layering my colors in a measuring cup. All the colors I'm using are listed in this video at the beginning, but also in the description box. And I'm not pouring from up high, because then the colors will bleed into each other. I'm layering them. I'm trying to do that. And the mix I use is Vallejo pouring medium 40%, Vallejo gloss medium 30%, and Vallejo polymer medium 10%. And I weigh everything. So I put some paint in a cup and I place it on my scale, and then I add the pouring medium, gloss medium, and polymer medium. And then I stir it that I have a nice smooth paste, and then I add the water that I have the consistency of warm honey. So I layer them all in my measuring cup, I stir it with my stirring stick, and I'm starting to pour on my Lazy Susan. There you can see it. I'm also tilting my Lazy Susan a little bit. And I don't use any silicone, so all the effects that I'm getting is because of the densities of the paint, because one paint is heavier than the other. Because I want to create some nice other effects, some that it has a nice flow, some nice stripes in it. And again, I'm pouring on the Lazy Susan. There you can see it. Tilting it. And this is what I also saw in one of the videos of Anna-Marie Ridderhoff. She has some paint in a bottle and she puts it under the paint you already have on your surface. There you can see it. Also the torch for the air bubbles. And it's very important with acrylic pouring that when you mix your paint, you put a lot of air in your paint because of the stirring. And then you need to let it rest for at least an hour, so that all the bubbles can come to the surface and will go away. Now I'm tilting it over the edge. And this is a commission, and what she also wants is more black than white. So not a lot of white, so that's why I'm adding more black to it. Again the torch for the air bubbles. And I also want to thank some people. I want to thank first all my sponsors for their support. That are Evelyn, Dolores, Laurie, Maria, and Abby. Thank you so much for supporting me so much. I appreciate it a lot. But I also want to thank the people that already use the links of my Amazon store to buy their products. I earn a little bit of money on that, so thank you so much, because although all the money I'm earning on it, I'm investing in this channel. But I also want to thank the people that use my Amazon wishlist, that sent me some beautiful gifts. So also for that, thank you so much. And also the people that watch my videos, thank you also for that, because I also earn a little bit of money on that because of the advertisement. And so all the money I'm earning goes right into this channel. So everyone, thank you so much for supporting me. I appreciate it a lot. And yeah, I can't tell you how much, but thank you so much for that. So my Lazy Susan, is almost covered with acrylic paint, and now I'm looking at the design if I like it or not. I have some great effects, but there also are parts that I don't like that much, and I'm trying to change that. And it's been a long time since I did an acrylic pour. So I'm tilting it. Let it flow over the sides to stretch the paint. And to see what kind of effects I can get. So one time my mix, I'm using all Vallejo products, and I'm using also only Winsor & Newton Galleria paint. What I do is I do my paint in a cup, I weigh it, and I put 40% Vallejo pouring medium in it, and I stir it to a paste. Then I put 30% gloss medium in it, also from Vallejo. I stir it again. After that, I'm putting 10% polymer medium in it. Stir it again to a paste. And then I'm going to add a little bit of water till I have the consistency of warm honey. Because it's all about consistency. You want not too thin, because then all your effects will be going away or flows over the sides. But also not too thick, because then you don't get any effects. So it's very important that you have the right consistency. Working on the sides. Again the torch. And all the products I'm using are listed in this video, but also I have linked them in my Amazon store, so you can check that out. And I have some great effects, but I find it a little bit too busy, so I want to change that. But I'm thinking, what should I do? And I have still a lot of paint on my surface, so there needs to be tilted some off. There you can see it, flows over the side. I'm stretching the paint. and I'm adding a ribbon. I've decided to do that because it's too busy in the middle. I'm tilting it to make it wider, the ribbon. And it needs more black because that's what she also wants, more black than gray and white. I'm filling up my measuring cup again and another ribbon in the middle. And again I'm tilting my surface. And again, I'm filling my measuring cup. And then adding another ribbon through the middle. Yeah, and all the effects you are seeing is without any silicone, because normally if you want cells, then you will add some silicone that will rise to the top, then you get those nice cells. But I don't add any of it. So all the effects you are seeing is without the silicone. Yeah, you can't see it right now, but yeah, I want to let it flow over the side to stretch it a little bit more. But still too busy. It needs more black. That's why I'm adding on that side also some black, to give it more balance. Yeah, and I don't want a lot of paint on my surface, because otherwise I have a risk that when it's drying that I get cracks, and I don't want that. So that's why I'm also tilting some paint off the torch for the air bubbles. Because if you don't do that, then you have all small holes in your painting when it's dry. And don't hold the torch too close to your paint or too long on one spot, because otherwise you burn your acrylic paint. And it looks much better now. And I think she will like it. And now we can go to the close-up. So this is after a few hours of drying. You can already see that on the outside it already dries, and with the Winsor & Newton paint it already it always dries, not shiny. So you get the shiny effect again with the varnish you put on it. But first it needs to dry for 3 weeks, and then I will clean it, and then I will give it several coats of varnish, gloss varnish. So all the effects you see is without the silicone, and I have some very nice effects, also some cells, but that is because of the density of the paint. Some very small cells. And I already sent her a picture of it, and she likes it very much, so I'm very pleased. And yeah, this was very nice to do again, some acrylic pouring where it all started. So I want to thank you all for watching, and if you have tips, questions or comments, place them under the video. You can also find me on Facebook and Instagram. Give me a thumbs up for this video, and I will all see you in the next one. Bye.